Victor is the CEO of the Fremont Street Experience. His role over there is to do a lot of things, but one of them is strategic development, another one is event creation, he's in charge of entertainment, and it goes on and on and on. There are many other things. And the Fremont Street Experience handles over 15 million visitors per year, so that number blew my mind. And I'm excited to talk to him, so put your hands together for Jeff Victor. Come on out. Hey, what up? Nice to have you on, thank you. Okay, I'm gonna switch with you. Over here.
All right.
Okay, so this is the first time in these seats.
Very tricky.
Oh, you brought a beer and you're sitting in one of the...
Somebody back in your green room fed me some beer, so...
Yeah, that's how we do it. All right, well, thank you for coming out.
Thank you for having me.
You wanna rotate in there, or is that too much?
No, I'm not gonna
okay,
do
okay. Okay, I understand that. All right, so Fremont Street Experience is an amazingly complicated thing. I mean, you got this... How much was that TV that you have up there?
Well, back in 1995 when it opened, it was about $75 million.
Is it the biggest TV in the world?
It is, yeah. Okay. About five football fields long.
Yeah, see, people say that Dallas Cowboys thing is, but we know it's not.
So no. That's not even one football field.
I think it's great. You guys ever played around with it and put some funny on there?
As often as we can, yes.
That's good. Okay, so well, I want to talk with your background. So
yeah, when I was going to college, I got a summer job at an amusement park, and that just kind of stuck. And then there were two industries that were colliding, the amusement park industry and the casino industry, and that was happening in Atlantic City at the Tropicana. And I went up there to open this 90,000 square foot thing, and I just needed a job after school.
Right.
And ended up defining a career.
Okay, well, tell me, how did it lead to what's going on here at Fremont?
Oh, my gosh. Well, you know, there's a path, right? And I'm getting old, so I've been a few places. But I stayed with the casino industry on the entertainment side and ended up being the president of an entertainment company that produced live shows. And somewhere between the amusement park background, live shows, casinos, tourist destinations all around the country, it all led me to here, and I've been here about 9 years now.
That's really cool. Okay, so has it grown as much as you wanted? Like, or actually, you know what a good question would be is, what happened that didn't get built? Like, was there other things that almost Fremont became?
Well, I mean, long before me, yeah, Steve Wynn changed Las Vegas when he built the Mirage, and the gravity was going to shift to the Strip, and largely because of his investment, the neighbors had to keep up. And so he told his neighbors down here, because he owned the Golden Nugget, that they were going to have to do something together. And he talked about his volcano down on the Strip. And so they came up with their own volcano. It ended up being the five football field long TV screen.
Yeah.
But it started as the Star Trek Experience. It ultimately went to the Hilton. It then was the Venetian Canals at one point. Finally, it was going to be the parade in the sky, the Mardi Gras parade in the sky that went to the Rio. And last minute, they changed to this concept, and it's been there ever since.
Yeah, that's so interesting. It's fun to imagine what all the different things it could have been, but it makes sense. You have a digital screen, which can be more versatile. You can put different things up there and kind of change it for the themes.
Yeah, software-based, so yeah, we get to change the content over the time.
Makes sense. Do you kind of miss the Mardi Gras theme, though? That would have been pretty fun.
Yeah, no, because I've seen it.
Okay.
I think they made the right choice.
That's cool. Okay, well, tell me some just fun experiences. So tell me about your job. It sounds exciting. Like, do you have a good story to share with us?
I don't know if I got a good story, but it is an exciting job. We have about 260 employees. We do see a whole bunch of folks that come down and have a good time. We're a destination inside a destination, and so of the 41 million people that come to Las Vegas, about 35% or so come down to Fremont as part of their visit, and we throw a party every night. If you wanna find somebody that throws a good party, find somebody that likes to go to a party, and that's why I think I'm well suited for my job.
Yeah, I like a good party. I could see that. That'd be good. Ooh. Okay, so tell me about for people who are here on Fremont.
I'm not gonna
attempt people
that.
Who are. So, I didn't know.
He's done this before. I'm not gonna do that on TV.
I haven't done it before, but I didn't fall over, which is what's important.
No, I think I'll just do the beer.
Oh, you're getting a lot of pressure. You want? I'll hold it.
All right.
No. Oh, you got a lot of pressure. No, I'm not gonna push it.
Yeah. Oh, jeez, you don't know how this feels.
Oh
my God! All right.
All right, well, Kimball, you better be ready too. All right, so okay, that's good. That's good. I don't even know what question I was gonna ask. But yeah, it sounds like a fun thing. All right, well, just tell me something super interesting. Oh, especially for people like that are on Fremont East, not visitors to Vegas for a weekend or something like that. Like, what should we know about the future of it, or what can we do to connect with you?
Well, I mean, let's just talk about the relationship between Fremont Street and Fremont East. I mean, I live downtown here at the Ogden, right between the two, and like I said, I've been down here 9 years. Early in my time here, I met Michael Cornthwaite when the DCR was under construction,
yep.
And I thought he was out of his mind. I thought I was out of my mind for being here, and we both started talking about, you know, the potential here, and he actually kind of gave me a view on the potential of downtown that was important to me. I've lived in a lot of cities, and so when people ask me, where are you from, I don't really know how to answer, and yet somehow I fell in love with the idea of developing a downtown core that was, let's face it, it was fairly defunct, and to see and be part of it growing up into what it is today has been a great experience in my life.
Yeah, it really has been. I would have never thought I was going to live in Vegas either, but it's all these guys, you know? It's a great place to be friends.
Yeah, absolutely.
So. Yeah, give your hands of applause. Look at him go. I love it. Yeah, I never thought that. Okay, so you had your own podcast for a little while. You were able to do some great guests. Tell me about your favorite experience on that.
Well, for me, I mean, I throw parties, and yet I'm really a business guy, and so to sit in the chair that you're sitting in right now, it was a real challenge for me.
That's a joke in itself.
I thought it was going to be a no-brainer, and then I went through training, and it's very clumsy. What he does is not easy, and I fumbled my way through about 10 episodes of a fun thing.
He did a great job.
And the idea was to bring the neighborhood together and show other people outside of the area that downtown collectively was an interesting place, and in particular we focused on the people behind the stories, and I had a great time doing that, interviewing folks and sharing their stories. I learned a lot, and I hope we taught some folks some stuff.
I'm sure you did. Okay, so last question is, tell me about the future of Fremont, but maybe also like what pulls you out of bed every morning. Like, what are you excited to continue tackling over the next 5-10 years as somebody who has a great position and a lot of power? Like, what do you hope to see?
Well, I don't do mornings very well, so it takes a crane to get me out of bed. I don't show up early.
Morning people?
No, and if there are morning people out there, I know
you don't know.
You've got a nice life, but I don't get it. And so I get out of bed and go to work, and the nice thing about my job is it's different every single day. And my staff really enjoys that. We've got about 260 employees. The core group that makes that happen enjoys wearing multiple hats through their day and their week, and the hours in the day and the responsibilities of the week are never the same. We throw a lot of special events, and some of them come up last minute, and so it's just a very fun, creative place to be. It's a great sandbox, and what's next? I don't know. We just opened the most highly attended zip line on the planet, and that's
you rode this.
Oh, I was the first rider, of course.
You were the first rider,
of course.
Nobody. Oh, I always say I'm going after that guy.
I wouldn't put anybody else on it until after I did it.
Oh, but it was cool. But there's some pretty cool technology in it, right? I mean, you guys thought up a new way to really create a zip line.
Yeah, myself and some others did have an amusement park background, and so zip lines are typically in the jungle with, you know, they're tied to trees or something ridiculously dangerous, and so we thought we would actually go the other way if it was going to be that high volume. And so we took roller coaster technology that had been existing for a long time, and we strapped it to a zip line for the first time. And it's extraordinarily efficient and safe. And we think we could change the industry a little bit worldwide if we taught a lesson. So
cool.
You're going to have a very good time.
Someone else can put up that giant Starship Enterprise and zip line off the front, you know?
Yeah, we spent the $18 million to make this one happen. Yeah. Somebody else can do the next.
Okay, well, thank you very much for coming
out.
We want to give you one of our certificates of
awesomeness. Oh, I get one? All right.
Oh, yeah, no, you've definitely completed the
I did the circle.
Camera.
I mean, I did
that. Yeah, do you think he deserves it for that?
No.
It's a lot
checked
of pressure
it off
with this audience.
I'm good.
So. All right, there you go, Jeff.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Appreciate
it. I appreciate it. Good seeing
you. Give a last round of applause.
Cheers.
That's awesome. Thank you.
Yep.
Warmed up.
I said don't mind, but do you? me.